Hello everyone, today we are continuing with the class 9 geography chapter number 2 physical feature of India. In this video we'll be mainly talking about the three features of the India. These are the desert, the coastal plains and the islands. So let's start with the topic. So first of all we'll be talking about the desert. Now the desert, you all know that the major part of our desert in our country lies in the Rajasthan states. So if we talk about the exact location of the desert, so it lies toward the western margin of the Aravali Hills. As you can see here, these are the Aravali ranges which lies in the northwest portion of the Malwa Plateau, which we have discussed in my previous in our previous video. Okay, so to the west side of the Aravali ranges we found the desert area. Now these desert area are undulating sandy plains and having a low rainfall. We all know that in desert area we mainly found the sands or the sand dunes, and these sand dunes, they are not the surface of the sand dunes are not plain, they are little bit wavy. So that is why they are called undulating sandy plains. Now here we also receive this area also receives very low rainfall, and because of that there are many small rivers are there which emerges at the time of the rainy season but also disappear because of the low rainfall. So in this region it mainly receives about 150 millimeter rainfall. Okay, now the only large river which found in this region is the Luni River. Now apart from it, barchans are also found in this region. And these barchans, they cover the major area in this region. Now, what are the barchans? Barchans are the crescent-shaped like structure which was formed when the wind blows. And these winds, they used to carry the sand particles along with them. And they keeps on depositing those sand particles at the windward side. And opposite to that windward side, we found a kind of a sinking shape. Okay, so that is why it creates a kind of a crescent shape like structure. And these barchans, they are shifting also. Means if you found a barchan in a one place today, so in next day you will find that barchan in other place. Okay, so these barchans, they keeps on shifting. Now next we'll be talking about the coastal plains. In our country we found the coastal plains which runs along in the peninsular region, and which runs along the west coast of our country runs along the Arabian Sea, and the east coast of our country runs along the Bay of Bengal. And we also discussed in my previous video that here in the western coast we also have the Western Ghat. So these western coasts are in between the Western Ghat and the Arabian Sea. In the same manner we found the eastern coast in between the Eastern Ghat and the Bay of Bengal. So if we talk about the western coast, these coasts, they are little bit narrow plains. So as you can see that the shady region, so these shady region are the western coast and this shady region is the eastern coast. So here you can see that we all know that the Western Ghat, they lies very near to the western coast. So that is why the area which is there in between the western coast and the Western Ghat, that area is called as a western plain. Okay, now so here you can say these are very narrow plain, but as compared to the Eastern Ghat, here the Eastern Ghats, they are little bit at a greater distance from the eastern coast. So that is why we found here the wide plains. Okay, now here we have divided the western coast into three strips. Okay, now these are the first strip, the northernmost strip is called the Konkan coast. Now what does the Konkan coast, here we have divided the western coast into three strips. These are the Konkan coast, Kannad coast and the Malabar coast. So the northernmost part strip is called the Konkan coast. Now this Konkan coast covers the Mumbai and the Goa region. Okay, now the Konkan coast got its names by the Konkani language, and Konkani language is mainly spoken in the Goa state. Okay, now next we have in the middle, in the center portion, we have the Kannad coast or the Kannad plains. Now these Kannad plains cover the major part of the Karnataka region. And you all know that in Karnataka, the people, they used to speak the Kannad language. In the south of the Kannad coast, we found the Malabar coast. Malabar coast covered the Kerala region, some part of the Karnataka and the major part, the whole part of the Kerala state. Now here, this region, this plain or this coast is called as the Malabar coast. Now what does the Malabar means? Malabar is the word, is the Malayalam word, and which means the side of the hill. Here, when we have discussed about the Western Ghat, that time we have also already discussed that in this region, in the Kerala region or the Western Ghat, we found the Nilgiri Hills and the highest peak Annaimudi and the Dodabeta also. Okay, so that is why in Malayalam, the Malabar coast means the side of the hill. The hill, the region which lies in the side of the hill. Those region is called the Malabar. Okay, so that is why it got its name. Now, if we talk about the eastern coast, here we have divided the eastern coast into two strips. First, the Nadan Sarkar, which starts from the West Bengal till the Odisha region. Okay, now Sarkar here means a province. You must be knowing that at the time of the Britishers, our country, Bengal is one of the major province at that period of time. Okay, so they have named this region, this coastal region, on the basis of the province. So Nadan Sarkar. Now the one more strip we have, one more coastal region we have, that is the Coromandel coast. Now Coromandel coast got its names by the Chola Mandalam. You all know that Chola Mandalam is the Chola dynasty, and which in our country we were having the Chola dynasty at the time of the 9th century. Okay, so this Coromandel coast got its name from the Chola Mandalam. Now next, the rivers form the estuaries. Now the rivers which flows or which drains into the Arabian Sea in the western coastal plain, those rivers they create or they forms estuary. Now what does the estuary means? As you can see here I have made two pictures. Now here you can see that the rivers which flows from the mountains, and when they drain into the sea, that time they do not split into the different streams, like as it happens at in the delta. Okay, like here you can see the major rivers, we have the Narmada and the Tapi. Now these river, when it drains in the Arabian Sea, because there is a very narrow plain here, so these rivers, they could not get space to get deflected or to split into other streams. So that is why they simply drains into the sea. So that is why these kind of rivers are known as the estuary, which do not form any kind of delta. Okay, now next is the rivers which are in the eastern coast. Here in the eastern coast we found many rivers like Mahanadi, Godavari, Krishna, Kaveri. All these rivers, they drain into the Bay of Bengal, and when they drain into the Bay of Bengal, they forms the delta. What is the delta? Deltas are the finger like projection. As you can see here, the river which flows from the mountain, later on when it reaches near to the sea, that time it splits into the different streams. Okay, so and they keeps on depositing their sediments there in between, and then they drain into the sea. So here most of the rivers, they drain into the sea and they create a kind of they forms delta. Okay, now so this is all about the coastal plains. Now next we'll start the topic, the island. Now you all know that we have the mainland in our country, and apart from the mainland we also have two islands which are the part of our country. These are the Lakshadweep island and the Andaman and the Nicobar island. Now here we'll be talking about the Lakshadweep and the Andaman Nicobar island. Now if we talk about the Lakshadweep island, these Lakshadweep island, they lies close to the Malabar coast of the Kerala. Now you all know the Malabar coast is there near the Kerala coast. Now so Lakshadweep lies near to the Malabar coast. And if we talk about the Andaman and the Nicobar island, so let's first discuss about the Lakshadweep island, then we'll go to the Andaman and Nicobar island. So Lakshadweep Island, it composed of the small coral islands. Now here in Lakshadweep we find the coral. This is called a coral islands because what are the corals? Corals are a kind of a organisms, microorganisms. Okay, these are the organisms which used to secrete a kind of a calcium carbonate, and because of their secretion, a kind of a corals were formed. Okay, so these coral very hard. Okay, they are very hard, and that is why they formed a kind of a island. Means when they keep on depositing those calcium carbonate, so when all the corals, they means attached to each other, so they form a kind of a island. Okay, now earlier the Lakshadweep island, earlier it was known as the Lakadweep, Minicoy and the Amandweep, but later on in 1973 it was named as a Lakshadweep island. So before 1973 it was known as the Lakadweep, Minicoy and Amandweep. Now the Lakshadweep island, it covers about 32 square kilometer area. Okay, and if we talk about the administrative headquarter of the Lakshadweep island, what is the administrative headquarter here? As we all know that Lakshadweep is one of the union territory of our country. So here we can say the capital of this Lakshadweep is the Karavati. So here we can say the administrative headquarter of the Lakshadweep island is the Karavati. Okay, now here we also find a Piti island which is uninhabited, means no person found there in that island, and we have a bird sanctuary there. Okay, so this is a Piti island which we found in the Lakshadweep island. Now if we talk about the Andaman and the Nicobar island, now these Andaman and Nicobar island, they are the elongated chain of the island in the Bay of Bengal. So elongated chain of the island means these are also a group of island. So here we have a two main island. These are the Andaman in the north and Nicobar in the south. Now these islands are elevated portion of the submarine mountain. Now what does it mean? When we discuss about the mountain ranges, that time we have already discussed that we also have the eastern extension of the Himalayas. Those are known as the Purvanchal ranges, which we found in the northeastern states. Okay, now these Purvanchal Himalaya also extended toward the south, and here we can say that Andaman and Nicobar Island, these are the southward extension of the Purvanchal Himalayas. Okay, so just imagine that here you can see that when our Indian landmass, it was hit with the Eurasian plate, that time these Himalayas were formed. Okay, so there were some mountain ranges or some mountains were there also in between the Purvanchal Hill, Purvanchal Ranges and the Andaman and Nicobar Island. But those Andaman and those mountains, they were less heighted. So that is why they were covered under the sea water. But these Andaman and Nicobar Islands mountains, they were little bit heighted. So that is why we were able to see the upper portion of the Andaman and Nicobar Island. So that is why now they were seems like an island. So that is why it was said that these islands are an elevated portion of the submarine mountain. Means the mountains which were there in the Andaman and Nicobar Island, the major portion of those island has been submarine, has been are there under the water. Only the upper portion can be seen, and those upper portion now are called as a island. Okay, now this region, the Andaman and the Nicobar Island, also experiences the equatorial climate, and that is why we have the thick forest in this region, because this region is very closer to the equator. Okay, here we can say the southernmost point of our country is the Indra point, which we found at the 6 degree. So 6 degree latitude. So it means 6 degree latitude is very near to the 0 degree latitude. So that is why we found the equatorial climate here. And because of the equatorial climate, it experienced a good rainfall. And that is why it has a very thick forest. Now, the last portion, as I have already told you about the corals. What are the corals? Now, all these corals, when they combine together, they forms a kind of a reef. Okay, so they are called reef. Now, as I have told you, these corals, they are of two type. One are, some are of soft, some are soft and some are hard. So, the hard corals, they form, when they are together, so they form a reef. Okay, now the reef are also of three type. Fringing reef, then barrier reef and the atolls. Now, what are those things? If we talk about the fringing reef are... means those reef or those corals which were formed along the seashore. Okay, and these fringing reef, they used to separate the sea water with the seashore. So that is why they were called the fringing reef. Now, if we talk about the barrier reef are those reef which are found at the greater distance of the seashore, and they create a kind of a barrier which do not allow the sea water to come in the near the seashore. And in between the seashore and the barrier, we found a kind of a lagoon. Now, lagoon is a salt water lake, and these are the static water. Okay, now next is the atolls. Atolls is a kind of a also a kind of a reef which is being made along any kind of mountain or an island. Okay, when the corals, they keep on depositing their corals, and this reef, when it appears above the surface of the above the surface of the sea, so it seems like a circular shape. It seems like a horseshoe shape like structure. Okay, so in between that circular shape, we found again a lagoon, and that lagoon is a saltwater lake. Okay, so this is all about this chapter. So in this chapter, we mainly discuss about the six major physiographic division of the feature of our country. These are, first we discuss about the Himalayan, the mountain ranges. Then we discuss about the northern plains. Then we discuss about the plateau, then desert, then coastal plains, and then the islands. So, by this we come to know that here, though we have a different kind of physical feature in our country, and these features are also very helpful for our country. Because through mountain, we get the sources of water, we get the thick forest there. Okay, then if we talk about the northern plains, these northern plains, they are the granaries for our country. And if we talk about the plateaus, from plateaus where we found the too much of the minerals, and these minerals are helpful for the industrialization in any country. And if we talk about the coastal plain, so these coastal plain are very good for the fishing purpose. Okay, and the islands also are very good for the fishing purpose. So all these things, they create a they means very helpful for making our future more developed. So this is all about this chapter. So in next video, we'll be starting the new chapter of class 9th. That will be the drainage. Thank you.